In the last 2 weeks, I've been working on a Neo Game Plus system for my roguelite game, in which Tuck can collect wisps, and these wisps will boost certain stats of your own liking. These bonus stats will carry on throughout every playthrough and make sure progressing through the game is just a little easier, because since this is a roguelike game, it's not fun to die at the same boss several times in a row. And this system will slightly help out with that, next to the own player skill, of course. Next to that, I did a couple of minor things like updating the UI bar and adding some more sound effects. More about this right after the intro. Hey everyone, and welcome back to another devlog about my roguelite game called Adventure of Tuck. So, like I've said, I've added a new system, which is basically a new game plus system. I'm gonna call it the Wisp system, since the points that you gain in my game are called Wisps. And basically these Wisps are there throughout every adventure, and you can use these Wisps to boost a couple of different selected stats. Before, I had a system of this already, which boosted some flat stats like health or damage, and of course this is very noticeable early on, but later on you don't notice these bonus stats at all anymore. And also before, you could only get these stats upon slaying a boss, and now it's still there that after you slay a boss you gain a wisp. And for example, for the first stage, if you defeat the boss you get one wisp, if you defeat the boss in the second stage you get two wisps, and so on. But next to that, I've also added wisps in chests. Every region will have 3 wisp chests, and every chest just contains 1 wisp. I think this is a way better system to actually get the wisps, because, for example, if a player keeps already dying on the first boss, it's not fun, and if you can just explore and find these wisp chests, then you can boost your stats and eventually just beat the boss. And another reason that I've placed these wisp chests is so it makes the player more likely to explore around and actually go and find these wisp chests. That's because I don't want the player to just tunnel vision on finding the boss and actually explore around a bit and find different kind of things. So basically, once you get these wisps, if you have more than one wisp, at the start of every adventure the wisp page pops up, and in this wisp page you can of course add some bonus stats. The ones you can see now on the screen are the bonus stats that I've implemented, but for the very first playthrough I'm gonna make it so not all of these will pop up. For example, like you can see the abilities, and you don't actually unlock all these abilities yet at the start, so it would be weird to just grind these wisp chests and already have like your best abilities at the very first boss without even having unlocked them naturally at first. So maybe the first time this wisp page pops up you only see the first 4 different kind of things you can add. And let's say after you beat the first boss, then there's some more wisp stats that pop up. So instead of the 4 that you saw the first time, maybe 6 of them pop up. This also helps to not overwhelm the player. This wisp page pops up and everything is on there. The player just gets stuck and is like, what should I level? And like for the start, I just wanna limit the choices a bit, so it's easier to choose. Well, next to that, all these wisp stats actually work. They've all been implemented already, apart from maybe the abilities. And earlier, as I said, the bonus stats that you got at first were like flat damage or flat health, and now I've made it percentage. This of course is not as impactful early on, but is more impactful later on in the game if you leveled up a little bit. And that's because most players are more likely gonna be more stuck later on than early on. And I think this is like the best solution for that. Well, that's enough about the wisp system. Next to that, I've added a whole bunch of smaller things, like for example text pop-ups for a level up, wisp gained or quest done. And next to that, I've updated the UI bar. I've had some people play test my game, and the thing that was noticeable was it's really hard to see when your ability is up, because of course you have to look at your mana. The mana is in the top left and then the abilities is in the bottom middle, and you just have to look around, like up and down, and it's really annoying. So the logical choice of course would be to just put them next to each other. So that's what I did. I had some problems coming up with a design at first, because I put the health bar and the mana bar right below the abilities, and then the experience bar would just look out of place, because you have something, for example, on the left side and nothing on the right side. So this is eventually the solution I came up with. And afterwards I realized that the UI bar kinda looks like the game Diablo, which is completely fine cause it just works. And next to that, what you can see is the levels don't appear anymore in the UI bar, but they do pop up if there's a text pop up when you level up, and they're still visible in Tuxbook. The reason I did that is because the levels aren't that beneficial to the game and important. It's not like you have a requirement to do a certain thing that you need a certain level for. It just helps you out a little bit with like bonus stats, and leveling just makes you slightly stronger and not like beyond overpowered or anything. And you can't really grind levels as there are a limited amount of monsters. Next to that, I've like animated the UI bar as well a little bit, just to make it look a little bit more visually appealing. As before, it was kind of flat and it looked kind of boring to me. And right now I'm really satisfied with the way it looks, so it's probably gonna stay like this. Next to that, I've added a whole bunch of sound effects. But it could be that all the sound effects are gonna change. I'm a person who's not really good with like sound related stuff, like music, sound effects. So I might get someone else to do that for me. But I'm not fully sure yet. Because for right now it works, and if there's gonna be new sound effects, then it's really simple for me to just add them. Well, next to that I've done a whole lot of like backend stuff, things you don't really see. And like bug fixes and everything, I've spent a lot of time on that. So this is actually all that I have to show you for now. I hope you enjoyed the devlog, and I hope you enjoyed the game I'm working on. If you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so, cause it would help me out a lot and it would motivate me to work harder. And like the video if you, of course, like my content. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully see you in the next devlog.